Hey everybody, so Rocking Cat Reviews gave me the opportunity to talk about Mega Man 1, 2, and 3 and the NES, and I really appreciate it. Thanks, bud. I played all three of the games, and what are my thoughts on them? So, other than factoids that, you know, people know about Mega Man, especially like diehard fans, you know, originally it was Rockman in Japan, it was created in 1987. And it was, there's like 50 different titles. It's a huge franchise. Everybody has their own memories because people kind of entered the franchise in different order. So, for example, I started with Mega Man X with one of my buddies in elementary school. And I thought that game was awesome. You know, you basically power up your character. You get more and more powerful. You get the plus up equipment, the E-packs, and Dr. Light's already dead. And he's basically, and you know, all they have are like recordings of him. I'm like, oh, that's so cool. That's such a cool idea. But anyway, and I've got Mega Man X3 here, and then, you know, of course, as an SNES kid originally, those are pretty cool. But going back to the point of this video, Mega Man 1, 2, and 3. What are my thoughts? First off, they're hard. Going back to these games, they're so challenging compared to latter installments. And I don't know if it's because in Mega Man 1, you basically can't slide, you can't, you can't charge your pea shooter, so you can't even, like Mega Man X, you can run around just like fully loaded, like he's got open carry, basically with his plasma blaster, and he can just, like, you can basically have yourself charged all the way up. And then run through the level, you know, as long as you don't, you know, blow your finger out and get carpal tunnel. Mega Man 1, you can't do that. And so I was like kind of blown away because I was so just, it's been so long since I played it that I forgot you couldn't charge your weapon. So it's kind of like with Bomberman when you, you know, you play the first game and you literally have to like detonate the bomb and you don't. It doesn't detonate by itself. That's just something I got used to in some of the later games. So, you know, different note, Mega Man, you have to go back. It, like, you can see where the basis for later games came from, but when you look at Mega Man 1, it's just, there's, you know, basic controls. There's run, you can't even walk. There's firing your pea shooter, not even charging it. And then there's jump, and he always has a little bit of slide or wiggle. So if you're doing like an air level, you can literally just one false swoop and you fall and die and you only have three lives. And or you get hit by enemies and you fall off a ladder and then you fall and then the level like freezes in between frames and then you fall and it, you know. And then my personal hatred, and not trying to be negative here, but I will be, is the puzzle blocks, the ones that, you know, they appear and reappear and you have to remember the pattern, and if you miss even one little bit, you fall. And that's on the, the snow or ice stage in the first game. Forget the boss's name. But I just found it to be really, really challenging, and it takes a lot of practice, and it's very time-consuming, and I don't care who the person is, but you're going to have to practice. You're not going to be able to walk into that game cold and get through it very easily. So, having not played any of these games for like, I don't know, 20-something years, it's pretty challenging. Going into Mega Man 2, it felt a lot like Mega Man 1. Similar challenge, similar control dynamics. It's almost like the game creators were like, okay, I'm going to take what worked, and I'm just going to change the bosses and the level design, and that's pretty much Mega Man 2. There might be a few more things. And so that was kind of my impression, but then Mega Man 3, you actually could slide, and the levels became a little bit more dynamic in terms of the color palettes and the graphics, and it just looked really, really kind of cool. But these are three very difficult games that started, it emerged a pillar of gaming in terms of a franchise that probably will never go away. And going into other games, so I've played recently, on my channel I have a play for Mega Man Battle Network, which is a different storyline. It's kind of more like coding, the kids learning to code, which is totally makes sense because all of the characters in Mega Man are robots. So Dr. Light basically coded Mega Man And you know, he basically created the architecture and the body and all that kind of stuff, and which is really, really cool, because I think robotics are really awesome. And then you've got more of the same, which is kind of the same storyline going from the original games. And I do like the design updates. So the first like six games, it's basically the same little blue pajama wearing robot, you know, because the graphics are so simple. And then you get into Mega Man X, and he starts to look more of like a advanced sprite, and it's got more, you know, animation involved and all that kind of stuff. But Mega Man, going to Mega Man 6, that was kind of one of the first games where you actually plus up your armor and your arsenal. And then you go into Mega Man X, and that area, that pocket of gaming where you're all about the equipment and plussing up his suit, and you really need to do that in order to get through the game, otherwise you get demolished really easily. But overall, I do think that going back to Mega Man 1, 2, and 3, I think they do hold up, because there's a certain mysticism to these games, because, you know, if you play it and then you step away for a long, long time, like, oh, how does that feel to play that again? It's overwhelming with nostalgia. And you also look at the environment that you played it into as kind of a factor. So it hit me because my family, and I think I've said this before, I was an SNES kid, and then we had a communal NES that the greater family owned, and it was at my grandma's house out in western Wisconsin. And this NES actually was shared by all the cousins, and we would hit it every holiday. And we had, I don't think we had all Mega Man 1 through 6, but we had like a one here, one here, one here. We definitely had Mega Man 6. We had Mega Man 3, and I think we had 2. And we would go through and try to beat the game every holiday. Or sometimes we would skip a holiday or two, because they're really challenging games. And, you know, if you take a couple months off and you don't really gun for beating the game, you're going to get frustrated and then, you know, stop. And I totally remember why I would stop playing, because, you know, you get all the patterns down, and then you may have trouble with one boss, take a break, and then you totally forget the pattern. So, like, for example, it's been so long since I played, I don't remember which bosses to fight in what order. And I used to be so good that I could beat all of them out of order, and it would just, you know, it was easy enough for me to do. Especially Mega Man X, you could totally do it there. But, you know, as a kid, it was like, oh, you got to do this boss first, this boss first, this boss first. And I didn't even look it up online. Like, I've got the internet now. I would just go in there, and I would play so much that I would just figure out, like, oh, you got to go to this one. It's like trial and error. And I don't know. I feel like as a kid, I had so much more patience than I do now. It's just hilarious. I might have had more ADD. I don't know. As I grew up, I got the H in there, the ADHD, but overall, it's really a treat to talk about this. I know I was supposed to talk for 10 minutes, but didn't want to hold up everybody too long. I think that the NES is really a pillar of the gaming, of the gaming community at large. I know it falls under retro gaming, but I think if people haven't played these early games, they are doing themselves a disservice. You really need to try it, you know, get some access to some of these older games, and then make your own opinions, because this is what games coming out today are based on. I mean, it's still elements that you can totally transfer. So anyway, thanks for watching. Hit that notification bell. Feel free to like, share, and subscribe. Rock and Cat Review stuff. You know, my stuff too. And also, I have I mentioned before, I have a store. I am always updating designs. I have one round of designs that I released. I'm working on some other ones. It's going to take me a little while to make those updates, because I'm, you know, short on time. No time, right? It's 5:40. But anyway, thanks for watching, and love to hear the comments and what your thoughts are on this. And this was really just kind of like my own perception on the games, a few factoids, but mostly like how I feel about these titles. So it's a lot of fun to talk about. It's cathartic. It's like, it's almost like therapy, right? You're talking about stuff that you remember as a younger person, and your thoughts. Did you enjoy it? Did you not enjoy it? Why didn't you enjoy it? Or why did you enjoy it? It's so fun. It's cathartic, and it's just, it's awesome. But anyway, Take care, and thanks for watching.